good day. This is me once again, your instructor or professor of the subject engineering economy. And today we are going to discuss the equation of value. So what is this equation of value? So by definition, this equation of value is obtained by setting the sum of the values on a certain comparison or focal date of one set of obligation. Take note, one set of obligations equal to the sum of values, okay, of the same date of another set. Now a simple cash flow diagram in which the borrower has borrowed amount or loan from a bank or a private entity, which we considered as our principal or the present amount, and then that borrower is going to pay that loan amount or borrowed amount in installment basis. Sometimes, for example, good for 5 years, maybe. So we let our n equals to 5, okay? So that principal amount or present worth is one set of obligation, no? We consider that one as this one set of obligation. And then that on the borrower side, in which he is going to pay that loan amount in installment basis, no, that would be another set of obligations to be done by the borrower. So sometimes the problem will give us a certain amount of installment basis for the first year, and maybe for the second year that borrower has no cash installment basis, maybe also for the third year, and for the fourth year maybe he had that cash installment payment to the lender. And then he will ask himself, no, the borrower's side, that how much money he will pay on the final year, on the fifth year in this case, how much money he will pay to set the obligation, no? To complete the obligation that he has to the lender or to the bank. So he needs to determine the amount of money he is going to pay on the final year or on the fifth year. And in this case, this equation of value applies, okay? So during the calculation, maybe we will consider the principal amount or the present worth in calculating the amount or the X value during the fifth year. Or sometimes we can also use or consider the future worth amount or the accumulated amount in calculating the X amount in during the fifth year, or n is equal to 5. This problem: a man bought a lot worth 1 million pesos if paid in cash. On the installment basis, he paid a down payment of 200,000 pesos, 300,000 pesos at the end of 1 year, 400,000 pesos at the end of 3 years, and a final payment at the end of 5 years. What was the final payment if interest was 20%? So we have now this final payment. So how much would be that final payment during the end of 5 years using the interest of 20%? So in this problem, since there was no statement that this is a simple interest, so we take this one as a compound interest, okay? So from here, you need to draw the cash flow diagram, no, of the problem. So actually, in this first cash flow diagram, actually we have until n equals to 5 years. So our n here is just 5 years, and this is our future worth for the accumulated amount with this formula, p times 1 plus I raised to the n. So why is this arrow going up, and why are these arrows going down? So we will take this one first. this 1 million pesos is going up because this is for the borrower side, no? The man was a borrower. Okay, so this 200,000 pesos is an amount which comes out from his own pocket, no? By the borrower's pocket. So that is why it's an outgoing cash flow or expenses. So that is the reason why this 20,000 is going downward. This, because this is a cash outflow on the side of the borrower. So as the 300,000 at the end of the first year, and for the X amount which is payable at the end of the end period, which is at 5 years. Okay, so this one, as you can see, we have now this principal amount of 1 million, and that borrower or man made a down payment of 200,000. So therefore 1 million minus 200,000 is just equal now to 800,000 pesos. Okay, so this will be now our principal or present amount due to that down payment, which is now at 800,000 pesos. Okay, so we have also this at the end of the first year, no, this 300,000. So in this case, according to the definition of the equation of value, this is now our one set of obligation, which is originally from 1 million, but that man paid a down payment of 200,000, so it was just reduced to 800,000 because we deduct that one to the 1 million. So this is now our one set of obligation, and below is just another set of obligation the borrower has to do. So he had to pay in installment basis, no? Installment cash basis, and until he can fully pay the amount at the end of 5 years, because the period here is 5 years. Okay, so now we need to use now the compound interest formula for our F. Okay, so here we have this formula, F is equal to P times the quantity 1 plus I raised to the N. Okay, so before we proceed with our calculation, I would like to emphasize that we will designate this term 1 plus I raised to the N with this designation. Okay, so here 1 plus I raised to the N is just, we designate this one as this F slash P I percent N. Okay, so we read this one as future amount given the present or the principal amount at I interest in N period. Okay, so or we can simply say that you are going to calculate the value of your F given the principal amount at I interest periods in at I interest rate or in N periods. Okay, so here this formula will then be equal to F is equal now to P times, we replace this 1 plus I raised to the N with this one, F given P I percent N. Okay, so this is just an equivalent to this formula, F is equal to P times 1 plus I raised to the N. Okay, so proceeding, if you can encounter, since from this formula P is equal now to F times 1 plus I raised to the negative n, because here this will be P is equal to F over this 1 plus I raised to the n. So we are going to raise this one up, so that is why this exponent will become negative. Okay, so P is equals to F times 1 plus I raised to the negative n, where our 1 plus I raised to the negative n is just designated as this one, P given F at I interest period, interest in n periods. Okay, so P given F at I percent interest in n period. So therefore, from this formula, our P equals to F times this 1 plus I raised to the negative n is just equal now to F times this P given F at I percent interest in n periods. Okay, so try to remember these two formulas, no, because we will use this one in our future calculations. Okay, so now proceeding, we have this one. So from this, since we are going to get the value of our P sub 1, so from the original formula, F equals to P 1 plus I raised to the n, so our P here is P is equal now to F times 1 plus I raised to the negative n. Okay, raised that to the negative n. Okay, so our I actually is, if we are considering compound interest, our I is just equal now to R over M. Okay, but in this problem, this does not indicate that there is a compounding. Okay, so if this will be the case, so therefore we can say that your R is just equal now to your I. Okay, because there's no indication that the problem says that there is a compounding, no. So if this is the case, you let your I just equal now to the rate of interest, no, this R, this is now our nominal rate of interest. So in this equation, we will use I, which is just equal to R, in which its value is 20%. Okay, so from here, P is equal now to, from this formula, we denote this P as our P1, and then our F, this value 300 as F1 times the 1 plus I raised to the negative n, in which this is then now equal now to F1 times 1 plus R, since our I is just equal now to this nominal rate of interest R, so raised to the negative n. Okay, so substituting, so we have now this F1 here equals to 300,000 pesos. Okay, so therefore our P1 is just equal now to 300,000 pesos times 1 plus 20% is 0.2 raised now to the our n, and here is 1 because at the end of first year. So okay, it is raised to the negative 1. So if you can substitute this one and calculate, P1 is just equal now to 300 times 1.2 raised to the negative 1 is 0.8333. Okay, so our P1 is just equal to how much? PHP 249,990 pesos. Okay, so this would be now our P1 here at the end of first year. So take note of this one because after we get the value of our P3 and P5, so we have to sum them up into P1 plus P3 plus P5 and equating this to our P equals to 800,000 pesos. Okay, so proceeding, we will consider now this at the end of 3 years. So we are done with at the end of the first year. Okay, so we have to erase this one and then we proceed with our next cash flow diagram. So we have now this cash flow diagram for at the end of 3 years considering the principal amount P. So here at the end of 3 years, so we have this installment cash or amount of 400,000. So since we are considering at n equals to 3, so we denote this here as P sub 3, where 3 is referring now to at the end of the third year. Okay, so here we are going to apply again the same formula. So we have, since it is P3, so P3 is equal now to F3 times 1 plus I raised to the negative n, okay? Which is equal also to F3 times P3 slash F3 I. Our I here is equal to R, which is 20%, and then our N is 3 because we are here at the end of 3 years. Okay, so proceeding with that, with this one, our F3 is just equal to this amount. Okay, this is our future amount and this would be now our present amount P sub subscript 3. Okay, so we have this 400,000 pesos. So if we are going to substitute this one, we have this P3 equals to 400,000 times this one, 1 plus, which our I is just equal to R, which is 0.2 or 20%. Then we raise this one to negative n, which is our n here is 3. Okay, so our P3 is just equal now to 400,000 times 0.5787. Okay, so therefore our P3 is just equal now to 231,480 pesos. Okay, So we already have now our P3 equivalent to this amount of 231,480 pesos. Okay, so now we are going to proceed to this n equal now to 5 years. Okay, so proceeding, at the end of 5 years we have now this cash flow diagram. At the end of 5 years, considering again principal amount P, which is this 800,000 pesos. So here we denote this one here as our P subscript 5. Okay, and then according to the problem, this amount is still to be determined at the end of 5 years so that he can fully paid now his obligation, no, to this set of obligation of 800,000 pesos. Okay, so our x here is just equal now to our future amount at the end of 5 years. So what will be the now our formula for this? So the same formula as to the previous P1 and P3, but we only denote this time as P5. Okay, so our P5 is just equal to F5 times 1 plus I raised to the negative n, which is then equal now to F5. We have now this designation for this P5 slash F5 given I percent, which is our I here is equal to R, okay, which is 20%, and then our N is just equal now to 5 years. Okay, so our F5 here, our future amount at the end of 5 years is equal now to x. Okay, this is just equal now to this x. So we have now this P5 equal to x times 1 plus our I is just equal to r, which is 20% 0.2 raised now to the negative 5. Okay, so we have now this relationship for our P5, which is in terms of x. Okay, so simplifying, it is equal to 0.4019 times our x. Okay, so this will be now our formula for getting the value of our P5, which is in terms of our future amount, which is our x. Okay, so actually we already get our value of P1. Okay, our P1 is, if you can still remember, this is just equal now to PHP 249,990, and then our P3 is just equal now to 231. Sorry, we are going to put this currency. It is equal now to PHP 231,480 pesos, and then our P5 is just equal to this, which is a function of our x. Okay, so here according to the definition, is one set of obligation is equal now to, according to the definition, is the sum of values sum of values, okay, with respect to a focal date, okay? The sum of values with respect to a focal date of another set of obligation, okay? So one set of obligation, which is referring now to this principal or present worth of 800,000, which is just equal now to the sum of values with respect to a focal date, in which in this case our focal date is at this n equals to 0, okay, of another set of obligations. So our another set of obligation is this p1, p3 and p5. So the definition says that it is the sum of values. So therefore, we can say that our P is just equal now to P1 plus P3 plus P5, okay? Where our P is 800,000, which is equal now to P1, which is equivalent to 249,990 plus P3, which is equivalent to 231,480 plus our P5, which is equal now to 0.4019 as a function of x, okay? So proceeding with this one, we can get now the value of our x, which is equal to our x is just equal now to this amount, 792,560 pesos. Okay, so we already get now the amount the borrower will pay at the end of 5 years to complete his obligation. No? So we have now this x value of 792,560 pesos. Okay. So proceeding, now I'm going to present to you, no, my own calculation. Aside from this method, actually I have an alternate solution of getting the value of your x, which is still equivalent to this amount of 792,560 pesos, but I am considering the future worth or our accumulated amount f. So I've just presented to you the calculation considering the principal amount. So in our next slide, I am going to present to you the cash flow diagram considering the future amount, which is still equal now to this value of x of 792,560 pesos. Okay, so proceeding, so an alternate solution for the problem, we have this cash flow diagram at the end of 1 year considering the future amount f, okay? So I am highlighting this one here as our f1 here, okay? So at the end of the first year or 1 year, we have now this installment cash of 300,000. So I will consider now the future amount. So I will start here at this point, no? Here. This would be now my focal date. Comparing to the principal amount, the focal date is here. But this time, I'm considering the future amount, so my focal date starts here at this point, okay? So here we have the formula. Since F is equal to P times the quantity 1 plus I raised to the n, okay, for the compound interest, which is equivalent also to this P, F given P, our I is just equal now to R, which is 20%, and our n here is, what do you think will be now our n? If I consider now this one as my focal point, so you will just count, no, from this, since this is now the cash installment, no, at the end of 1 year, 20,000. So I'm starting here as my focal date, so I'm counting from here 0, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So here is our n is 4, okay, because I'm going to have this n, no, from this focal point until this end of first year, which is equivalent to 4 years. So that's why our n here is 4 years, okay? So substituting now, our P is just equal now to, since this is now our F1, so our formula for this F1 is equal now to, this P will be now our P1 times 1 plus our I is just equal to R raised to the N, okay? So we have now this F1 equal now to our P1 now is, our P1 now is equal now to this one, because this is now my F1, okay? So this will be now my P1 here, okay? So we have 300,000 times 1 plus 0.2 raised to the, our n is 4. So 300,000 times this 1.2 raised to the 4. So our F1 here is just equal to how much? 300,000 times 2.0736. So we have now this value of our F1, which is equivalent to this amount, 622,080 pesos, okay? So we are done with our F1, okay? Here, for at the end of the first year or 1 year. So we are going to calculate also our next future amount when we are here at the end of 3 years, okay? So proceeding, this is now our cash flow diagram at the end of 3 years, considering the future amount F, okay? So now, we have this simple cash flow diagram, where our focal point here is at this date, okay? So at the end of 3 years, according to the problem, that borrower have this cash installment now of 400,000. So in this one, we have now this formula. So we denote this here as F3, because at the end of 3 years, so this will be now our present worth or our P3, okay? So from the formula, F is equal now to P 1 plus I raised to the n again So this will be now equal now to F3 equal now to P3 times 1 plus this I is just equal now to R raised to the our N here is we start here, so our N is 1, 2, so 2 years, okay? Okay, so this one is just equivalent to P3. We have this F3 given P3 at 20% and our N is just equal to 2, okay? So proceeding, our F3 here is just equal to 400,000 times 1 plus 0.2 raised now to the square, okay? So our F3 here is just equal to 400,000 times 1.44 here, and then consequently our F3 is just equal to this amount, which is 576,000 pesos. So we have now this F3 already. So we've got the F3 and the F1. Okay? So at the end of 5 years, we also have this cash flow diagram considering the future amount. Okay, so proceeding again, we have this cash flow diagram at the end of 5 years considering the future amount F. So here, we have now this formula F equal again to P times 1 plus I raised to the N, okay? And then since we are considering at the end of 5 years, so therefore, we can say that our F5 is just equal to P5 times 1 plus 0.2 raised now to the, what will be now the value of our N here? Okay, so since we are here at this focal point, which is our focal date, so here, we don't know the value of our X, no, the final payment at the end of 5 years. So our N here at this point, since this is our focal date, is just equal to 0. Okay, this is just equal to 0. So this is just equivalent to this P subscript 5, then we have now this designation of F5 slash given this P5, okay, 20% at our N is just equal to 0. Proceeding, so our F5 is just equal now to where this our P5 is just our X, the final payment at the end of this 5 years. So this is just equal to X times 1.2 raised to the 0. So any number raised to the exponent of 0 is just equal to 1. Okay? So therefore, our F5 is just equal to X. Okay? So we have now this F5, since we are already have the F1, the F3, and this time the F5, which is just equal now to the value of X. So what we are going to do now after getting this, so we have now this. And again, one set of obligation is just equal now to the sum of values with respect to a focal date, in which in this case at this point. So we have now this F is equal now to F1 plus F3 plus our F5. So we are going to use now this formula in getting now the value of our x, okay? The question now is, we don't have yet the future word, no, of this one set of obligation here, because we are only given with this principal amount of 800,000. So this time we are going to get the future word at the end of 5 years here using this given 800,000 as our principal or present word. So by formula, our future word, so here we have to indicate here the future word of the principal amount, which is in this case it is equivalent to 800,000. Okay, so proceeding. So we need to determine the future worth of the principal amount, which is this 800,000. So by formula, we have this F is equal to P times 1 plus I raised to the n, where in this case, our P is just equal to that 800,000. And then our I is just equal now to the R, which is 20%, okay? And then our N is just simply the, since we are considering this present amount, we are going to get the future amount with respect to this principal amount of 800,000. So from here, it is 5 years, okay? 5 years. So substituting, we have now this value of our F equal now to 800,000 times this 1 plus I is 1.20 raised now to the 5th. So our future amount here is just equivalent to how much? Equivalent to 1,000,000. Okay, so we have here 800,000, 1.2 raised to the 5 is 2.4883, which is then equivalent to 1,990,640 pesos, okay? So we have now this future worth now at this focal date in terms of 800,000, which is our principal amount, okay? So proceeding with our calculation, we have now this F is equal now to F1 plus F3 plus our F5. And then this F is just 1,990,640, which is then equal now to 622,000. Our F1, 080 plus our next F2, F3 is 576,000 pesos plus our value of x. So calculating, our value of x then is just equal now to 792,560. pesos, which is still the same if we are going to consider the principal amount. So it's either you consider the principal amount or if you are considering also the future amount, the result will still be the same. I'm getting the value of your X at the end of 5 years, which is equal now to this amount, 792,560. Like, share, and subscribe for more updated videos regarding our subject, engineering economy. And thank you very much once again for listening and watching. God bless us all.